Here's a story of fun with science. Who has spent the last year stuck in quarantine? All of them had 1 year left, except for Finley. Pandemic means that there's no jobs. It's a story of the newbies who were torturing their families with their jokes. Andrew, Molly, and Michaela, yet they were all alone. Till the one day when they came into auditions, and the scientists knew they would fit right in, that this group must somehow form a family. That's the way we all became the Funny Bunch. The Funny Bunch, the Funny Bunch. That's the way we became the Funny Bunch.
Jellyfishing, jellyfishing, jellyfishing.
What's up, y'all? It's DJ Tommy Tits.
And I'm Lil Crimes.
Yeah. Hey, yo, Lil Crimes. Can you believe we've been studying remotely for over a year?
Oh, my God. Don't remind me, Tits. But thanks to these two sassy ladies,
Muhlenberg is back in business, bitches.
Did you miss us?
Hey, yo, Crimes, where the party's at?
Not so fast, Tommy Tits. Campus looks different, but it's come equipped with some brand new features that'll make you wanna
spit in a tube!
Let's take a tour!
We've got
passive-aggressive size, occupancy limits, and fruit wrapped in plastic.
And you know we got plexiglass screens all up in this bitch.
What are they saying?
Nobody knows!
Hey, Krabs, what am I even gonna do on campus? I'm gonna be fucking bored!
Nonsense! There are plenty of fun activities to do!
Like what? Sit in my dorm?
Well, let's see. You can...
sit in your dorm! Go for a walk! Or wait for your food! Uh-oh, spoiler alert! It's fucking cold!
And who could forget?
Do you mean
the testing program?
Oh, fuck yeah!
Boom! Pow! Nosebleed!
No way, Lil Crimes. This semester seems pretty dull.
Hey! Put your mask on, douchebag! Have a great semester, Muhlenberg. And remember, if you're spotted within 6 feet of someone,
Dean Goliath will put you in a chokehold!
And here's your host, Brian O'Conan!
So anyway, ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to another episode of
Dead People Talk Show!
I am your host, Brian O'Conan, and ladies and gentlemen, we've got quite the show ahead of us tonight. I'm joined again by my charismatic host, as always, Abe the Beard Lincoln!
It's from my experience that those who have no vices have very few virtues.
I always say that. Ladies and gentlemen, let's get right to the show tonight. Our first guest, you've seen him in Mary Poppins, you've seen him around the streets, it's Dick Van Dyke! Take a seat, take a seat. That you died of a brain aneurysm in 2003?
What? Oh, Brimey, I didn't die!
No, it says here that you did die. It says that on my card. And my producers are saying that we have
a clip from the funeral. Roll it.
I'm still here. I'm an American icon.
I don't know about that, but are you serious? Who sent him out here?
I am glad to be back on the telly, though. You know, I can still dance me a little jig.
Throw me bells! Stepping time! Stepping time!
Stepping time!
Stepping time! Oh!
Stepping time! Stepping time! Stepping time!
Oh. No better time than now! Yes. We'll be going to break.
You literally can't hear a
this fucking.
Let's get it. Well, this is the last room on the tour of the place, and there isn't much else to tell you. Don't like the way I fish, answer emails, you know, the usual.
Well, I'm so excited to get started, thank you.
Yeah, we're happy to have you here. Now, I just need you to sign some forms. Let me get them real quick.
Who is that?
Who is who?
The small child in the ratty clothes who probably has lice.
Oh, you mean our Victorian orphan?
Your what?
Our Victorian orphan. Every office has one.
They do?
Yeah, it's a part of any good functioning office ecosystem.
Felicia!
Oh, God!
Spare a pretty penny, something to eat, sir!
Do we not feed him?
Yeah, he's more of a beg for scraps kind of fellow.
Mum's died of the boils, see, sir, and sister's got the cough, see, sir, and brother's got the late-stage polio, see. They need their strengths up. I'll get what's left.
Oh, I'm so sorry to hear that. Is there anything we can do?
Oh, well, I mean, we give him a place to stay and something to do, so, I think he has all that he needs. And besides, it's not our fault that he's living under the societal standards of 1800s England.
Yeah, and besides, I likes eating me boiled cabbage. Plus, mums would want me here. Keep me from muffing around outside and all.
Cool, kiddo.
Oh, today is Friday, so that means it's pizza day! Not for you! Bad! No! Bad!
No!
Wait! Empty your pockets.
Orphan!
Meet Rebecca, just your typical girl next door, trying to do it all in the Big Apple. She's got it all, except someone to share it with.
Honestly, I'm just done with dating. I don't think there's anyone for me.
Don't give up hope. I feel like the one is just around the corner.
She's ready to walk down the aisle, but the right aisle for her isn't the one she expected.
Oh, sorry.
No, it's my bad.
Oh shit, I meant to get lettuce. What am I gonna do with a cabbage?
Hey, you're not too hot yourself, sister.
It's the classic love story with the twist you've been waiting for.
I feel like ever since I've met you, I've been so much happier.
It's probably the lowered cholesterol levels. Maybe you would want to move in? Come on, let's take the big leak. Leap.
Yes, of course.
Mom? Dad? This is Caleb.
But he's...
He's the one.
I'm sorry, but he's a fucking cabbage.
Charles!
I knew it! I knew they'd never accept me!
Caleb, I'm so sorry. I don't care what my dad says. I love you. Je t'aime, mon petit chou.
Forget it, Rebecca. You're a smart girl with a bright future. And I'm just a leafy green packed full of vitamin C.
You may be full of vitamin C, but let me show you how I see you.
Caleb, you're wilting!
It was only a matter of time. I just wanted to spend the time I had left with you.
No! No! Caleb!
Vegetable human love isn't a sustainable lifestyle. Be warned. A Walk Down the Aisle is coming to theaters near you on April 1st. Paid for by the Family Research Council.
After my wife left me.
We know he did it. He fits the profile perfectly and he has a motive.
Plus, all of our other suspects have rock solid alibis. Unless this is truly a random crime, he's our guy.
It can't be random. Our evidence shows that the unsub has known the victim for years. This is personal. If only we could get him to talk.
Still nothing?
It doesn't matter what I throw at him. He just stares at me. It's like he's in some kind of invisible box. I can't get through.
More bad news. Lab results came back negative. He didn't leave any fingerprints behind, and DNA was inconclusive. It's those damn gloves. He's too careful.
So all we got is the home security image of him leaving the house?
It isn't enough. Camera couldn't capture his face under all that makeup, and we can't indict someone based on a striped shirt and suspenders. We need to get this confession. I'm going in.
Detective. If you can't get him to talk, I gotta let him go. I'm sorry, we're out of time.
Why'd you do it, huh? Bear with me, I'm just trying to understand how someone could do such a pathetic, despicable thing and then sit in that chair without a slight ounce of remorse. Did he look at you funny while you were working? Did you feel like you could prove your manliness by killing him? Or maybe you were just looking to feel something. Anything to break up the monotony of your meaningless, despicable life. Huh? Say something, damn it! Stinks!
Just trying to get used to a few things.
Well, if you have any questions, just let me know.
Actually, there is something I'm still trying to wrap my head around.
Oh, is it Tom? Because the smell is a medical condition, I think. You'll get used to it.
No, it's actually about the small child who's the office servant.
Oh, the orphan? You know, you throw him a couple pennies here and there and he gets off your back.
But don't you find it, the slightest bit odd at all?
Look, he comes with the turf, okay? What, have you never been in an office building? You guy. Hey, little scam.
Did something happen to your leg?
Ah, no, it's just the old plague acting up again.
Well, at least the polio cleared up.
He still has eradicated diseases. We don't vaccinate him.
Dude, have you seen our health plan? We don't even get dental.
Yeah, it's not all bad. It's not all bad. I could be the old office medieval serf.
Your sole promotion you should be looking forward to is the one after death, my lord.
Alright, welcome back. Sorry for the mix-up earlier.
Our interns were dealt with accordingly.
Isn't that right, Abe?
Yeah, a woman is the only thing I'm afraid of that I know won't hurt me.
So true. Our next guest tonight is an American, a family man, and it's Buzz Aldrin. To Earth. So, how do you feel after dying of that brain aneurysm back in 1983? I mean, with living a lie, you know, with the fake moon landing and such. I mean, the moon isn't even real.
What an asshole.
Aw, man, what am I gonna do? First Dick, now Buzz. Oh, I'm ruined.
Don't give up, Johnny. It's the groove and the swing and the moving, Tony Bennett.
Wait, Tony, you're not supposed to be here till tomorrow.
I sleep in the green room, Johnny. It's where I get my freak on.
My name is Brian O'Conan. Did you just say that you've been banging in the backstage?
Yes, sir! The missus don't mind.
All right, well, we can probably just fit you in now. Mm-hmm. It says that you died from a bad romance with Lady Gaga.
Wrong again, Jimbo. I'm still crooning and swooning like it's 2019.
It's 2021.
Wait, Reagan's not president anymore.
Back to break. Yo, I thought I dealt with you interns.
Grandma, the turkey is too delicious. It should be illegal.
What did you say?
The turkey is delicious?
Stand back! I won't go down for this!
FBI, drop the spatula! Drop it! You're going to jail for a long time, Grandma.
Pirates who don't do anything, count down the
Go Bruce Springsteen!
In this kitchenette, even
we're doing this today. Come in, I suppose. This is Stanislavski. Male strip with signature. Stella Adler, beautiful as ever. And we have Nicolas Cage. Now, if you follow me. What? Have you never seen Wicker Man? Brilliant work. Come on. I make art. Well, the inspiration for the studio came about when I was abroad. In London.
Hey everybody, welcome back to the London vlog number
642. Gonna be pranking the owners of this fucking pie shop right here. Gonna be sick. All right, so smash that motherfucking like button. Let's go. Oi, where your fucking pie's in it? In that space, it allowed me to hone in on my artistic craft.
What artistic craft? He missed half the classes.
I meant to ask, before I start speaking, can you make sure that it's just showing my silhouette and that you do, like, what those docuseries do where you make the voices really low? I just want Thomas to know that I'm talking about him. Hi, I'm Owen Yingling. I studied abroad with Thomas Riley, and to say that it emotionally scarred me would be an understatement. This man had such a negative effect on my life that I had to immediately start therapy because I couldn't deal with the effects of Thomas. One thing in particular that I always remember is he'd always wake me up every night right on the dot, 11:15 p.m. And he would say, "Hey, Owen Yingling, I hope you know that I'm more talented than you are." And the other thing that affects me more than anything else was the night of November 23rd, about 1:30 a.m. I heard some noise to my left, so I woke up and all the lights are on. And there is this shirtless, pantsless man just standing confidently in the middle of the room. He's practicing stage combat in his underwear. No decency. I can't get that image out of my head no matter how much I try. And I'm gonna have to live with that forever.
Acting is all about preparation of the mind. Preparation of the body. Would you like an example? I'd love to give you one right now.
No, that's okay.
No, I think we should.
No, it's okay. No, wait, no, Thomas, that's okay. Don't worry about it.
That's fine, keep filming.
No.
Keep filming! John Lennon. So I like to incorporate primal animalistic movements into my daily routine.
Wait, what?
You following? Shall we? With classes being online, I try to build a digital community. Eno, I want to make my little ones feel welcome.
Hi!
Shut up!
I start with a few get-to-know-you games.
And that's when I said, "Oi, there's your fucking pies in it." I studied abroad in London.
You have daddy issues, don't you?
And then we get to work.
And with a golden ticket, it's a golden day. How was that, Mr. Thomas?
You think you have what it takes to play Charlie in a middle school production of Willy Wonka and the Chocolate Factory, Junior?
Well, gee, I sure hope so.
I've seen better acting from the turtle I ran over with my car earlier!
You what?!
Listen to me, you little shit. Do you smoke? Stop taking some fucking chances with the character!
This documentary will be finished when? Friday. Wonderful. Let me know if you have any questions. Thanks for stopping by. Toodaloo! Bastards. Lord. Allentown Taps got me acting funny.
Sun will come out tomorrow. Bet your bottom dollar that tomorrow.
Oh, crap. Printer jam?
Yeah, I'm gonna have to stick my hand back there.
Oh, no, don't worry about that. We have someone for that. Orphan, see if you can get your hand back there and get one of those papers that got stuck.
Aye, aye, sir.
He's got them tiny, grubby hands to get into those industrial nooks and crannies.
Are you sure?
Here you go, sir.
Jesus!
Ah, don't worry. It's me third finger this month.
happens all the time.
Good job, Orphan. Here's a nickel, or whatever you call it.
Oh, a tuppence! You're too kind, sir.
Just a tuppence? What's even the conversion rate on that? I don't know, but it's more than we pay our interns.
Team can be hard. I constantly feel like I need a place to vent, but have no idea where to turn. Luckily, I have the new secret password journal from Mattel.
We here at Mattel get that your youngster needs a place to keep their secrets, and now they can. Thanks to our new diary, your teen will always have someone to whisper secrets to.
I love this diary. As a young man, I have a lot of trouble expressing my emotions. Thanks to my secret password diary, I don't have to be embarrassed anymore.
Finally, a true confidant.
I feel like this acne will never go away. It is so, so, so weird.
Dear diary, I totally have a crush on Tony! But I know you'll never tell, though.
My dearest diary, I feel so alone. All of the others have been staked by vicious mobs. I truly have no one but you, my only friend.
And with this new voice-activated entry, they can make sure their secrets stay secret.
Palm tree.
Flower petal.
Death.
Our state-of-the-art voice identification system makes sure that no one can steal your secrets, especially not pesky little brothers.
Flower petal! Flower petal!
Rats!
Ha ha ha! Thanks, secret password diary!
Open, you box of mysteries!
Thank you, secret password diary.
Thanks to the diary's compact design, it's super easy for me to take it on the go. I can carry it just like this, or I can stick it in my bag with my school supplies.
I love that with this journal, I can take my feelings wherever I go. Lizzie is being such a dumb bitch right now.
Becky, I can totally hear you writing all those mean things in your dumb diary. Stop.
My dearest diary, the craving for blood grows stronger every day. Soon, I fear I will no longer be able to control it. I do not want to become this monster. I am disgusted by who I've become. Not fully alive, not yet blessed by death. This constant thirst to kill and feed is draining me of all hope.
So thank you, Secret Password Diary, for keeping my secrets secret.
Thank you for letting me express myself.
Thank you, though I worry that you are my last connection to humanity.
The Secret Password Diary, available only at Walmart and your local Merchant Square.
Look at this adorable baby. Look at how cute she is. Well, every morning, she wakes us up by scratching at my face until I give her breakfast.
You haven't even asked! Will this stop? Damn it!
Alright, everyone. Boss is gonna be here any minute, and we still don't have that company-saving pitch.
We've been crunching the numbers, but we just can't figure it out.
Not now, Orphan! You know not to get from your box when the boss man is coming!
I'm sorry, I couldn't help but overhear you, gents, and I think what we got here is—
Quiet, you! You're just an orphan! Go back to your sweeping if you know what's good for you!
Stupid.
Your Majesty, welcome, please. Well, I'm here. Now, if you lot don't give me that company-saving pitch, I'll have your heads.
We don't have any.
Oh, I got one.
Quiet, you. Our apologies, sir. He's just our orphan.
Silence. Let him speak.
Well, I've been running the diagnostics, you see, and what I found out is we need to revitalize our assets to ensure no liability risk and ensure no calamity on our net loss profits. So, if we do a cash flow return on our investments, we should be able to cross out our expenses on the balance sheet and increase overall profits for the next 4 terms.
Oh. No, don't spray that orphan yet. My boy, I have been waiting for someone with such intellect, such skill in business, to rise to an occasion such as this. I'm only getting older, and I have been worried that this company would die with me. In honesty, I came here tonight looking to find an heir. And by golly, I think that orphan just might be it. Someone who could fill my shoes and follow in my footsteps, keep this company alive. What happened to the little bugger?
I think the pox finally got him. Yeah, he's dead.
Oh dear. Right, you're all fired.
Up next, we have 3 straight hours of food spinning in a microwave. And join us later for Dead People Talk Show with a special interview from everyone's favorite orphan.
My new job mainly consists of haunting old curmudgeons until they change their evil ways.
Guys,
what if we like took 2 snakes and put them in like a thing of Tupperware and then we just like have them fight? That could be pretty fun.
Yeah, that's like straight up animal abuse.
Yeah, no. It's all ironic.
Guys! I just came up with the funniest idea this joke of a sketch group has ever heard.
Who let this guy off the saddle, huh?
I'm serious, Thomas.
What is it, Owen? We just can't think of anything.
All right, fuck me then.
Yeah, Owen, let's hear it.
Will eat his own shit?
President speaking. This could work. This could definitely work.
All right, guys, so here's the scripts. Will, you're going to play yourself. Thomas, you play Chrissy.
Aye.
I can't wait to dig into this giant, steaming, heaping pile of my own shit.
Okay, right, Will. There's no way you're gonna eat that shit. I bet you can't even scarf it down in 8 seconds on camera.
I'll show you. Watch this. And then it says, Will proceeds to eat his own shit on camera.
Oh, God.
Funny. I literally cried.
Thank you.
All right, well, I guess we should talk revisions now, you know, edits.
Oh, I've got nothing for this.
I mean, what else is there to say, Owen? This is a home run, buddy.
Yeah. Great job, Owen. I forgive you.
Wow. Yeah, Owen, great job.
Hey, Owen. You know, I really just wish she told me you were writing this, because I don't know, I don't feel like...
No, but that's the best part. You see, this idea came to me in a dream last night, and you were in it.
Okay.
You were the shit eater, so I just stayed all up all night, and I wrote it out. Finished it this morning.
He has a God-given gift.
Right, I just, you know, I think you could have taken it in, like, literally any other direction. But
oh,
this.
And hey, buddy, hey, look. Hey, guys, I'm sorry to bother you, but I'm feeling this energy right now. And as an actor, sometimes when you have that spontaneous energy, you just have to film. So I need you to film this right now. Okay, I need you guys to let me out of this table.
And we totally can film today, because today just happens to be the day that I brought my huge steaming pile of shit.
Hey, guys, can we talk about this?
No!
Guys, I'm trying a little too hard. I'm trying to marry a little too hard.
Okay, places, people. Alex, prime the shit.
Look, guys, I just don't feel too cool about this.
Look, Will, do you want your equity card or not?
Yeah, Will, be a team player. We're all doing our part. Why can't you?
You're talking about a sketch where I eat my own shit!
Oh, boo-hoo. It's not even your own shit. Pipe down, Will.
It's still shit! Like 6 pounds of it!
Fine, cut! Cut! I'll compromise. You don't have to lick the plate. Christ, what happened to actors who can commit? Marlon Brando would have happily lapped that up.
Yeah, and I mean, it has a pretty strong aftertaste. I mean, 6 pounds might be a little much.
Guys, what the fuck? I mean, why me? Why shit?
No, Will, this part is you. You were born for this role. I envisioned it for you.
Yeah, well, see, the thing is, buddy, I do it myself, but you see here, it clearly says Will eats his own shit.
President speaking? Will? Gotta be you.
Think of the children, Will. Think of the children.
Well, Will, I think you got your answer.
Okay, I guess I'll do it, but... I mean, 8 seconds...
Don't worry about how long it takes. We can just speed it up in post. And... action! And cut! That's a wrap. Great job, everyone. You were all so crucial to this process.
Guys! I just came up with a really good impression of a lesbian. Could be a sketch.
You suck, man.
Guys, I just came up with the second funniest thing that this joke of a comedy group has ever heard of.
Will get stabbed outside of 7-Eleven at 4 a.m. and bleeds to death?
President speaking? This could work.
You were under arrest. Shouldn't have uploaded that video to YouTube. No one wants to see a 45-minute mime video. Also, you confessed to the murder in the subtitles.
Hey, your pro- oh. Oh my god.
My name is Mary. I'm kinda scary.
I crush the tea.
Welcome back! And what an eventful night it's been. Oh, excuse the blood. I just got done mercilessly beating our interns.
There are two things a person should never get angry at. They can help, and what they cannot. It's a quote by Plato.
Okay! Our last guest this evening looked terrifying for decades before his untimely death in 1996. It's the creepy, the courtly, Prince Philip! You're looking great, Prince. Miss the Queen. But you're not. She got a point. I don't know what to do anymore. The show is a wreck.
Disdains the beaten path. It seeks regions hitherto unknown.
You're right, Abe. I think he's finally croaked. Well, at least we have one dead guest, right? Oh, god damn it! Why won't anything work? Oh, I need at least one dead guest.
Well, thank you for watching, everyone. Thanks to Jimi Hendrix for your terrific performance tonight, and stay tuned for the Masked Singer.